Once the radioisotope is bound to an appropriate organic molecule to produce the radiopharmaceutical, further steps are necessary before it is administered to humans. The reaction mixture from radiosynthesis has impurities, including side products, unreacted starting materials, and radio decomposition products. It is very important that the radiopharmaceutical is present in the intended form to avoid undesired effects when it is injected into the body. To achieve reproducible results for imaging and therapy, purification, formulation, and quality control are performed. The radiochemist chooses the most efficient way to purify the radio tracer, formulates it for biocompatibility, and performs quality control to check if the formulation is stable and meets the required standards. How can we purify radiopharmaceuticals? There are different techniques, including radiation detector-equipped high-pressure liquid chromatography, solid phase extraction, gel filtration, and centrifugal filtration. Let's talk about their main features. Radio-HPLC exploits liquid chromatography to separate the different components present in the radiopharmaceutical, and a radiation detector is attached downstream, works in real time to identify these components. In this illustrative radio-HPLC chromatogram, the blue line shows the number of organic compounds in the mixture, whereas the red line in the spectrum is obtained from the radiation detector. In this case, there is one major radioactive component as shown by the single red line peak and one major organic component as shown by the single blue lined peak. Since both the peaks coincide, it is possible to assess the incorporation of the radioactive species into the organic molecule. Solid phase extraction purifies the molecules from a mixture based on their polarity. The desired product can be isolated by eluting with organic solvents. Gel filtration and centrifugal filtration separate components based on size. In gel filtration, the sample is passed through the stationary phase using gravity or air pressure. The smaller components get trapped in the cavities in the stationary phase where larger molecules pass through. In centrifugal filtration, the separation is achieved by centrifuging the sample through a filter with a specific mass cutoff. The centrifugal force helps the filtration process by pushing the masses lower than the cutoff through the filter while retaining the desired product on the filter. After purification, quality control takes place. This involves several specific tests and measurements that ensure the characterization, purity, biological safety, and efficacy of the radio tracers. The quality control tests used for radio tracers not only include those for typical radiopharmaceuticals, such as determining the pH, osmolality, and ionic strength, but also tests for radionucleidic and radiochemical purity. Several techniques are used for this purpose, including radio-HPLC, instant thin layer chromatography, or ITLC, liquid chromatography mass spectroscopy, or LCMS, gel electrophoresis, autoradiography, and gamma spectrometry. In ITLC, thin strips of stationary phase are spotted with analyte and mobile phase travels by capillary action. This leads to separation of the individual components of the mixture due to differences in polarity. The ITLC scanner uses a gas fill proportionality counter to scan the whole TLC plate at one time. This analysis shows the number of radiolabeled species and if there are any free radioisotopes in the sample. Gel electrophoresis separates charged molecules according to their size using electrical potential difference. Typically, this technique is used for radiolabeled biomolecules like proteins and antibodies. The radiolabeled molecules are loaded into indentations at one end of the gel and an electric current is applied across the gel to pull the molecules through the gel. After the separation is complete, the gel is exposed to an X-ray film inside the autoradiograph, causing blackening of the film due to the presence of radioactivity. Molecules with lower weight move the furthest down the gel, and approximate molecular weight of each radiolabeled component can be gauged using a reference. The information and data obtained by all the cited techniques enable us to evaluate parameters related to product yield and purity. The radiotracer yield can be expressed as the activity yield and radiochemical yield. The activity yield is the amount of radioactive product obtained which is not corrected for decay, whereas the radiochemical yield is calculated from the decay-corrected activity of the product expressed as a percentage of the starting material. With regards to purity, it is important to assess the absence of other compounds, that is, chemical purity, as well as absence of other radiochemical compounds, that is, radiochemical purity. The radiochemical purity is determined by ITLC and radio-HPLC from the integrated area under the curve, or AUC, of the desired compound. This is expressed as a percentage with respect to the total area under all the peaks. In the illustrative chromatogram, there is only one main peak and the radiochemical purity is nearly 100%. Simultaneously, from the optical detectors of the radio-HPLC, the chemical purity of the radiopharmaceutical can also be obtained. Finally, as we have learned before, the radioisotopic and radionuclidic purity can be assessed using gamma spectrometer. In addition, other quality control steps are required for use on humans. This include analysis for sterility and bacterial endotoxins. Maintaining these standards require proper management, training, and self-auditing. The purified radiopharmaceutical needs to be injected in biocompatible intravenous fluids. These fluids are designed in such a way that they leave the intravascular space and enter the intercellular spaces, allowing uniform distribution of the dissolved radiopharmaceuticals. Common intravenous fluids are salt or dextrose solutions whose concentration is adjusted to fit the tonicity requirements. Certain additives could also be added to optimize the shelf life and stability of the radiopharmaceuticals during transport and administration. The process of making the radiopharmaceuticals ready for patient administration is called formulation. For human use, good manufacturing practices, or GMP, ensures that the products are consistently produced and controlled according to quality standards. The GMP guidelines are dictated by regulatory authorities, and compliance is checked on a regular basis. The post-synthesis steps of purification, characterization, and formulation complete the process of a radiopharmaceutical production and get it ready to be injected into patients. The dosed patients can now undergo imaging or therapy.